Ministry of Energy and Mineral Resources has moved to study the controversial power supplying company Umeme's limited concession, which has come under intense criticism from power consumers. This after complaints by customers arising from what they say are increased power tariffs that do not translate into units after subscription. The same prompted the president to strongly condemn the power supplier, vowing to deal with the company. That and more in the NRM Manifesto 2021 Roundup.
During the ongoing NRM Manifesto Week held at the office of the Prime Minister in Kampala, the Minister of Energy and Mineral Resources, Mary Goretti Chitutu, Umeme's concession has negatively impacted the power sector. This follows a public outcry on the increased power tariffs, which do not translate into given units after subscription.
But also, we also need to put into context, at the time when Umeme came, how was the economy like? I'm told we're categorized in the economy of C minus. That means the country was considered at high risk. So whoever brought in money wanted to put us at a very, the economists know, the interest rate was higher. Now, Umeme came in through an international bidding process and were the lowest bidder with a return on investment of 20%. So that's what we have studied, but we are restudying that and to see how we can better that concession. And if not, then we as government, if we wish.
On the issue of the oil exploration project, Minister Chitutu revealed that Uganda will start drilling its own oil and selling it within the next 3 years. Over 2 million jobs are expected to be provided in the oil project.
So my appeal is for Ugandans to take advantage of this. I'm seeing actually more, okay, we have the East African spirit, but more of our neighbors are even more keen to come and ask for information, more than the locals. So my appeal is we be alert and know, get knowledge on what is required for us to benefit in this industry. That's what I wanted to add on.
On rural electrification program, Chitutu said in the financial year 2020-2021, an additional 2,896.66 kilometers of medium voltage lines and 4,219.21 kilometers of low voltage lines were established. All district headquarters have been connected to the national electricity grid except Kotido, Buvuma, Kabong districts. However, land acquisition for government projects and vandalism on the transmission line and installations have posed a major challenge.
Secondly, I indicated that we are procuring city buses. We are trying to put into place a mass transport system. Instead of using commuter taxis which carry 14 people, we want bigger capacity vehicles, such that we reduce on the number of vehicles which plow the city. We also want to put in place a conducive and efficient public transport system. This will help us to say that even some people who come to offices can use it, and they leave their vehicles at home. When this is put in place, I'm very sure the congestion will reduce. So that's the big plan we have, and it will be achieved under the implementation of the Greater Kampala.
The Ministry of Kampala and Metropolitan Affairs also presented their sectoral performance in the National Resistance Movement Manifesto Week. In the Greater Kampala Development Plan, plans are underway to restructure the transport systems in the city centre. Top on their list is to reduce the taxis operating in the city centre and introduce buses, revamping the railway services, among other services. Namugwanya also revealed that plans are underway to register all border riders and give them uniforms for easy identification. This is expected to reduce the crime rates attributed to borders. Also in the plan, border free zones will be established. The ministry revealed that they have also been able to fulfill the presidential pledge to develop Kampala City and currently 600 kilometers of the 2,100-kilometer road network across the city's 5 divisions are paved, 5 new roads have been reconstructed, while rehabilitation works are ongoing on over 40 city roads. The ministry is also struggling to implement the Kampala Drainage Master Plan. The NRM Manifesto Week continues tomorrow. This story was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Kampala.